I know what you're thinking. What is that thing? Well, it's a homemade Hydroseeder that you can build yourself. And I'm going to show you how. So this is a couple years old. It's getting, some parts are getting wore out on it. So today we're going to upgrade the tank. We're going to get that off of there. We're going to switch to a 275-gallon ICB tote. Right now I'm going to put it in the back of a flatbed truck so we can use it there and make it mobile. And then after I have that figured out and the dimensions, I'll probably build a small wood subframe for it. And then I'll come back and we'll build that out of steel. I don't think we'll get to steel tonight because I think this is just going to be a trailer at some point. But I just want to get this going with a bigger tank, higher capacity, and get her back operational. So let's go get the tank. So here's the tank. It's a 275-gallon ICB tote. Paid around $45 for it. I bought two of them at the time. This one used to have food grade material in it. I believe it held some type of yeast or something. I don't know. But we'll get the tank cleaned out and we'll get the valve off the end swapped out with something that we can use. Because these come with weird screwy threads on this that you can see. It's not standard for anything we're going to find at Home Depot. So I got an adapter for that. So we'll get that swapped off of there. So right now let's try and get this tank around this shed and back, or around the shed back inside the shed. Yep. So I got the tank over here and we're gonna throw it in the back of this thing. And for now, this is gonna be our temporary, whatever, trailer guy thing until we get time to figure out the base and build an actual frame.
Catching every single thing possible.
It's everything that looks. So again, the issue with these is the threads, which they make adapters for, and in my case I happen to have one which goes from that weird thread to a normal 2-inch thread. That should give you transition from here to standard pipe. So we can start dismantling the original one. We'll get these, it's called bulkheads. They pass through. This is the actual jet that circulates, same as this one. We'll get these off of here. And then the original garbage tank unhooked. And see if we can keep going. Let me show you the bottom. Just a through hole for the bulkhead and that. So I think if I loosen this, it should push this back and this should disconnect. That's the theory anyways. One of these should move. Because that is another bulkhead. Which you can see it right there. Alright, I'm having a heck of a time getting that fitting off the inside there. Can't get to it, so I don't know. I hope we can just loosen this bad boy up. How it's gonna work. I think that should just undo it. We just don't have a way to get to it. Got it. And then we can take this guy, throw it away. So effectively all this pump is you get your main inlet feed, which goes in here, and this valve, this one, is now here's your output, this output, it goes out that tube, but this is your bypass. So if you shut this,
and open this, it'll recirculate the mix back into the tank.
And so it just churns it up the whole time until you get a good slurry that you can apply.
Could be more level, but yeah, whatever. But yeah, I think these two, depending on the screw I put in here, they're the same height. So when I go to build a trailer, I just build it all one height. This should be slicker than I ever thought. So let me get you in here. If you take a look, usually these two are gonna mate up. So this is just the natural height of this pump and the natural height of that tank based on that. So I'm gonna take this rubber coupler, cut this end off. It should give me a rubber union for these two. Should work pretty slick. Okay, there. So there, just get another hose clamp and we should be able to mate these together. If you ever take a stuff apart, save the hose clamps. These things are expensive and they're not getting cheaper. So like right there, probably just saved $6. Save your hose clamps off everything. So we're gonna take this guy, slide this back, slide that on there, about halfway, it's where it used to be. Tighten that down. That driver would be way better. I don't have one. This guy. Oh, I almost forgot. That guy in there, insert. Put this over top. And we should have a union with some vibration reduction, so the one doesn't shake the hell out of the fittings on the other. But let me actually get a nut driver and get that tightened down, and then we'll get the motor bolted down, and then we're gonna have to get some extra line for some new line. We'll get a couple more feet of this hose right here, this guy. It's just, this stuff's old. I don't wanna mess with it. And I'd rather have these kick out just a little further. So, and then we'll cut some holes in the tank for the bulkheads. I just want to reiterate again that this is a temporary setup. I'm going to make a frame and a trailer for this. This is just to get it working for now. So, yeah, I'm about to screw this down to the bed of this truck. And the old nuts that we're holding the motor on, and the washers, Reuse. Huh? Care. Trying to do two, although it looks like the second one is exactly in the crack on the boards. But whatever. I'll feel better about it. Yep, totally won't clean them. I should hold it. Relatively stable for what I'm doing. It's not perfect. Again, temporary. So, sorry about the light. We're hooked up there, and I think we're going to put one of them here, and then we'll probably in the opposite corner on the side. What that allows us to do, so when this is in there, I can turn it so it can blast down, over, whatever, just keep churning. So keep it at like an angle, that just keeps stirring everything up. So, that's the point anyways. I don't know if it'll work like that, but we're gonna give it a shot. So I have an insanely long drill bit here. And what I do is I'm actually gonna run it backwards. Well, let's take it back. The forward's the start. Now backwards. I'm going backwards so it melts it. It's just a cleaner cut. So now I'll reach through my hand, I guess, set the camera down to this, and push this bulkhead through that hole.
I just got done adding some bracing here, just so this stuff's more stable, so when it gets pulled on, it doesn't break off. Scrap wood, again, temporary. But I believe that's going to do it for tonight. As far as I can tell, we're ready for a test run. So tomorrow we'll drain the gas out of here and fire it up, see what we can do. Hey, welcome back. Finally had a chance to get this thing cleaned up and go through the carburetor real quick, put some fresh gas in it, drained the bowl, cleaned out the needles and such, started first pull, plug is good. So the motor works great. And basically, this is how this thing works. This is a pump here connected pretty much direct drive to the motor. And then this is our inlet off the tank. This is where we mix the grass seed, the mulch, and the tackifier. That's that blue or green snot you see on the roadside after the DOT goes through and sprays the ditches to plant grass. Anyways, so we dump that in there. We let it mix for a while. We shut this valve because this one is the discharge chute, which goes there to our spray nozzle. And this one is just the recycler. So this recycles half that way, half that way. One on this side of the tank there, and the other one is right here. There's an elbow inside here. It's directional. I think right now it's pointed down. We'll mess with it, figure out what works best as far as which way it should point. But basically all it's supposed to do is just agitate the mix, get it to stir up real good, really mix up the stuff and get the tackifier turned into basically liquid snot. So then after you do that for about 10 or 15 minutes, you will shut this valve, and you'll open this valve, and this is going to stop the recirculator, and it's going to force it out to there, and then it gives you, you get your here with your on off on the end of your gun. So, and that in a nutshell is about how all these things work. They might have a little better recirculating deal, might have a little bigger pump, but in a nutshell, that's it. Let's get some water in this thing, just test it out and see how it does. We're about ready to fire this bad boy up. We got the tack fire. This isn't going to be a how-to Hydroseed, but we'll just show you quick. One bag of this to about 125 gallons, 20 pounds of grass seed. We're going to make a slurry of that thing and then shoot it out of that thing over to there. So let's get to mixing. Get a little further away, so that's going to mix for about 10 or 15 minutes until it turns into a nice snot like slurry. Basically it's just liquid paper, or paper in pellet form, turns into liquid like snot. It's got a tackifier in it, so it holds the seed down and traps moisture in, so that way if you mill like this and you get a rain right away, it won't roast too bad. It'll actually hold in place, the roots will take hold. So it's the next day, forgive the mowing going on in the background, but we did the spraying yesterday, and I think we're going to try and adjust the nozzle. I got one of these laying around for another project, and I think we're trying to heat this up, squeeze it, see if I can get more of a splatter fan instead of like this jet stream thing it currently has. So let me grab the torch, give this a shot, heat it up, stick it in the vise.
So I have a bunch of these, so let's try it again. This one, I may have overdone it. Pretty good. Like it. Way better. Here's a new tip, see how it does. Water. Where is it? Where's my stuff? There it is. Yeah. Way better. Yeah, a lot more coverage than we had. We can still, you can throttle the pressure up and down here, and also on the pump, don't forget. So we're only running about, not quite full throttle. This is only about 3/4. Cost. Okay, I know you want to know. You're dying to know what the cost is. Well, let's go over a little bit. So, pump, $40. Facebook. Tank, about 45. The two Banjo valves, or 2-inch valves, those are about 25 a piece. Hose, miscellaneous other stuff, about another $50 or $60 total. So, really didn't cost that much. It's cheaper than renting one twice. Is it perfect, you know, industrial grade? No. Will it work for small stuff? Yes. And you can build it off of stuff you can find on Facebook or you have laying around. So, whatever. Anyways, we'll see you on the next project. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe.